from pre-K through UA. We're ranked second to worst in the nation, and we should be second to none. We need to provide more opportunities for students to succeed. This means access to quality pre-kindergarten programs. We know that that is the surest way to close achievement gaps and improve student performance for our neediest students. We have to continue to forward fund education and adequately fund education so that teachers, parents, and students have stability and certainty in their education futures. We also need to provide the university with the resources they need to continue driving Alaska's economy forward. That means a skilled workforce, continuing world-class research on the Arctic, and increasing our ability to ensure that our Alaskans achieve the degrees they need to be successful. We're united as a body to put the permanent fund dividend in the Alaska Constitution. We want to protect it for future generations. Today, politicians can ignore the statutes and take your PFD, drain the earnings reserve account, and in only a few short years, the PFD could cease to exist if we don't address this issue now. We've seen also nearly $17 billion in savings spent in only 4 years. The potential for the earnings reserve account to be drained is too great to ignore. Senate Democrats have introduced a couple of different proposals to start that discussion. We're hoping that that debate is robust and that we come to some significant decisions this session. It's time for Alaskans to decide the fate of their permanent fund dividend and to take it out of the hands of politicians. Finally, we need to ensure our communities are safe and secure. My new colleagues, Senator Keel and Senator Gay Jackson, will talk more about that in a moment. The main purpose today is not just to tell you about those policies, but to introduce to you our new members. So with that, I want to introduce to you, on my left, Senator Scott Kawasaki. He's one of our three new members of the Senate Democrats, first elected to the House in 2006. He served on the Resource Committee and the Finance Committees in the House. He brings a wealth of expertise with him to the Senate. He also will serve on the Resources Committee and the State Affairs Committee here in the Senate and on the Joint Armed Services Committee. So with that, I introduce you to my friend and colleague, Senator Scott Kawasaki. Senator.
Thank you. Thank you, Senator Begich. So I'm not new to the Capitol, but new to the Senate, so it means I know where the restrooms are. I've really sort of hit the ground running with some legislation and sort of understand some of the issues, but the Senate is definitely very different. And I think I jumped from the House just in the nick of time, as they're not yet organized. Alaska faces a number of significant issues, similar issues that we've faced for the last 6 years. This is the sixth year, or could be potentially the seventh year, in which we have a major budget deficit. The Governor Dunleavy's budget has a $1.6 billion budget deficit headed our direction that the Finance Committee will have to tackle. I've said this all along, that one of the ways that we can really ensure that we don't have this huge budget gap is to look at oil and gas taxes. I've been a member of the Resources Committee since my freshman year. We had, the Alaska's Clear and Equitable Share, which Governor Palin championed. We changed that under Governor Parnell. We've made tweaks here and there. But the state of Alaska simply is facing a massive budget deficit. And our per barrel credit that we have put in, or that the legislature, previous legislatures have put in place, is $1 billion to $1.5 billion that is costing the state of Alaska. If we can look at oil taxes, which I hope that we will have a chance to do in the Resources Committee, that will be a big step in closing our budget gap. I'm really optimistic about this legislative session in the Senate. I'm excited to be a member. One of the key things that I heard going door to door, it's very important for my constituents, is the permanent fund dividend. And I know there's a proposal from the governor that just came out. There's a proposal from Senator Wilkowski to ensure that Alaskans maintain that permanent fund dividend. And I think that's a crucial thing that this caucus is going to be working on over the next 90 days. So I'm looking forward to working with my new colleagues in the Senate, folks across the hall in the House, thank you, Senator Begich.
Thank you, Senator Kawasaki. On my right is my very good friend, Senator L.V. Gray Jackson, who represents Midtown. She replaces former Minority Leader Senator Berta Gardner, who taught me the ropes. You know, so Senator Gray Jackson has over 34 years of public service, nine of those on the Anchorage Assembly, where she also served as chair. Before that, she was the budget director for the Anchorage Assembly. She understands budget, she understands politics, and she understands how to govern. With that, I want to introduce to you my very good friend, Senator L.V. Gray Jackson. Senator.
Thank you, Senator Begich. I am new to this level of government, but I want to tell you, I know where the bathrooms are also. Now, more than ever, we need leaders in Juneau who are willing to work together on behalf of Alaskans. That's the bottom line. Alaska's budget shortfall is still the number one issue, and state lawmakers, they haven't addressed it yet. We need to build a comprehensive and sustainable fiscal plan that will work for all of us. We can't just continue to rely on oil revenues because it creates instability to our budgeting process and ability to carry out and provide essential services to our citizens. We need to maintain and improve Alaska's infrastructure through a GO bond, because it's vital for our economy, for our economic growth, and it'll also provide sustainable jobs for our hardworking men and women. The high cost of health care, it's affecting local communities, our businesses, and nearly every single aspect of our economy. We need to seek ways to drive costs down. We need to do that. We also need to maintain access to Medicaid and fully fund it so that we can provide our citizens with the health care that they all need. Crime has impacted all communities throughout Alaska. We need to rebuild communities and make them safe again, because public safety is a basic, vital necessity. I want to ensure that revenue sharing is continued to be provided, because these are the funds that's provided to communities that help our communities pay for police officers, firefighters, and other emergency medical personnel. Thank you. Thank you, Senator Begich.
Senator, thank you, Senator Gray Jackson. Senator Gray Jackson will also be serving on the Labor and Commerce Committee and the Community and Regional Affairs Committee. Finally, last but not least, our hometown Senator Jesse Keel, who will represent also not just Juneau, but represents also Haines, Skagway, Clequan, and Gustavus, will be serving us on the Resources, Judiciary, and Transportation Committees. Of course, you may know him for his service on the Juneau Assembly, which I think you left on Monday. Is that correct?
Monday night.
Yeah, Monday night. So 8 years on the Juneau Assembly and 18 years as a legislative aide, in particular as a finance aide. So a lot of finance expertise here at the table. With that, I turn it over to Senator Keel. Welcome.
Thank you, Senator. Appreciate that. All those years have taught me not to talk about bathrooms. But I do want to welcome all of you from the press corps and my colleagues here in the caucus, as well as throughout both bodies, to the capital city. We have a tremendous group of leaders sent from all over Alaska here to Juneau to do the people's work. I will have the privilege of serving on the Judiciary Committee in this legislature, and it's a big job. There's a lot to do. I think Alaskans throughout our state have spoken very clearly. Crime is too high, and it's risen a lot in the last few years. Election is over. It's time to get past party concerns. It's time to get past bumper sticker slogans and get to work. We need to rebuild safe communities. We need to fix our criminal justice system, and we need to do that by focusing on the things that really work. We need to invest in the things that prevent crime in the first place, that keep people from reoffending when they get into that criminal justice system. You know, this increase in crime predates the criminal justice reform of a few years ago. It really started in 2015. It tracks closely with opioid addiction. It tracks even more closely with tremendous cuts to law enforcement, cuts to district attorneys and prosecutors, cuts to troopers, and cuts to police at the local level. There are no surprises there, right? From 2014 to 2016, there were 7,000 criminal cases dismissed because of staffing cuts at the Department of Law. There's no surprise, really, that you see crime go up in a situation like that. We see cities prosecuting more misdemeanors, which cities have the power to do in Alaska. That is essential to respond to those crimes, but it's on the back of the local taxpayer. The state didn't really save money. The state shifted money when it cut law enforcement to local taxpayers. So we need to really focus on strengthening our justice system, and that begins with hiring more troopers, more VPSOs, more local law enforcement. It also includes prosecutors and public defenders. It's essential that we pay them a good wage. It's essential that we provide a competitive retirement. And that means a chance to earn a pension, which is available to law enforcement everywhere else in the country, but not Alaska. We're losing law enforcement because of it. We also have to focus on the things, as I said earlier, that prevent crime, that stop people from reoffending. That means drug addiction treatment. It means alcohol treatment. It means mental health services. Senator Gray Jackson alluded to that, and quite simply, we heard a call to slash social services recently. If you want to increase crime, it's one of your fastest tickets there. We need to address the things that lead people into crime. We need, bottom line, to make Alaska's communities safe again. I'll stop on criminal justice for now. I have the privilege of serving on the Resources Committee with Senator Kawasaki and with the chair from Anchorage. I just want to emphasize, Alaska has some of the best laws in the country to do resource development right, to both create jobs and protect our environment for the future. And I look forward to working on those issues and making sure that we do both for all Alaskans. Thank you, Senator.
Thank you, Senator Keel. And I should reinforce that you also serve on the Transportation Committee, which is critical for Southeast. That said, I would be remiss if I didn't introduce our two most senior members of the caucus again and remind you that they are our representatives on the Finance Committee, where they will, Senator Donnie Olson from Golden has been a marvelous asset on the Finance Committee for years, knows the ropes, and Senator Bill Wilikowski is new to the Finance Committee this year, but understands the ins and outs of oil and gas taxation and our oil and gas policy in the state of Alaska. So with that, we open it to questions. Noah Hansen, our press assistant, who's here, will give you the mic. James?
James Brooks from the Anchorage Daily News. Do you folks here believe that there's support in the legislature for $1.5 billion worth of cuts like the governor is planning to propose?